Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, now we are going to learn today about data structure. As I mentioned before only, data is what? Unprocessed material, and information is processed data. Now we are going to learn about data structure. Data structure is basically a systematic way of organizing the data so that it can be used efficiently, so that it can be searched efficiently whenever we require it. So while learning data structure, we need to go through the basic terms of data structure. The first basic term comes under the data structure is the interface. Interface, each data structure has its own interface. Interface represents a set of operations that can be performed on a particular data structure. An interface provides a list of operations that can be performed on the data structure. Type of parameters which you are going to pass to the functions which you are going to call on the interface. Interface also defines the return type of these operations which are going to do. So interface is basically what? Each data structure has its own interface. Interface represents a set of operations that a data structure can perform. Support. Next, implementation. Implementation provides the internal representation of the data structure. Implementation provides the definition of algorithms which are going to use so that we can use data efficiently while storing also and while retrieving the values also. Now, the most common question which we asked, data structure is a programming language? No, data structure is not a programming language. It is a set of algorithms which helps us to organize the data in an efficient manner, manage so that it can be stored efficiently and retrieved whenever we need. Now we are going to learn about characteristics of a data structure. Every data structure should follow these characteristics. First one, correctness. Data structure implements the interface, so all the data structure should implement its interface correctly. Next, time complexity. Time complexity is basically the running time required so that the algorithm can be completed, so that the execution time is minimum. So time complexity is basically the time required for the execution of your operations, set of operations. Now, if it is possible, keep it as minimum, as small as possible. Minimum the time execution, minimum the time complexity, better is your algorithm. Next, third one is space complexity. As I mentioned, time requirement, just like that, space requirement. Now, space is what? Memory requirement. Just like as possible, you should keep your time complexity minimum. Similarly, memory usage. Memory should also be minimally used. In other words, we can say memory should be efficiently used. Why we need to learn data structure? Let's say the examples of today's applications. Everyone is carrying data. So data is growing day by day. It is getting richer and we can say complex day by day. Common problems which are faced in today's world. First one is data search. Let's take an example of an inventory. Suppose we have 10 millions of data items in a search. So we are going to search one particular item. Now out of that, we are going to search one particular item out of 10 millions. So the process of whichever it is the fast, it is going to make comparison for each and every data item. So due to this, the data search is going to be slowed down. We are going to surely go to find the data, but at what time and at what space we are going to find is also very important. So data search should be instantly done. For this, we need data structure. Second point, processor speed. Let us take the example of today's world. However the fast the processor is, let's say example if you have 10 billions of data, now to search that data, processor is going to surely shortfall. Processor speed is however high, it is going to be slowed down as it is going to search instantly with the number of times comparison. So the processor speed is also very important. And the third one is multiple requests. Let's examine example of Google. Millions of users are searching their data, continuously searching their data, whatever information they want to search on the web servers. So multiple requests are going to be handled. Now your processor, your computers cannot handle this data. Even the faster server will fail if it is not properly searched or it is not able to handle multiple requests at the same time. So these are the three basic problems which we face in today's application. First one is data search. Second is the processor speed. And third is multiple requests. So to handle these problems, to solution to these problems is data structure. Data structure is basically how we organize the data, how we are going to make it sure that we are going to search the data efficiently, we are going to get the data whenever we are required, and it can support multiple requests at the same time. So data structure is used to solve this common three problems: data search, multiple requests, and processor speed. Advantages of data structure. First one, efficiency. Efficiency of a program depends upon the choice of selection of your data structure. Let's take example of 10 billions of data items need to search. The example, we are going to use array. Now, to store that value, I need that much memory space. Now, just take example, I am able to store that much data. Now, I need to search it. So, for searching, array index starts from 0. So, I need to start from 0 to search the 10 millions data. That is not a practical solution. In data structure, we have different implementation methods, different formats to store the data. Example, tree, graph, linked list, stack, queue, which provide a much better implementation of the data structure as compared to your arrays. Next one is reusability. Now, what do you mean by reusability? Reusability is what we write once and use again and again. Reuse is called reusability. In data structure, I need to provide the implementation, and that implementation of data structure can be stored into libraries which can be given to the clients who can directly use it and reuse the implementation of data structure. The third important advantage of data structure is the abstraction. Data structure has ADD. Now, what do you mean by ADD? ADD is what? Abstract data types. It does not provide the complete implementations to the user. User knows only the basics one. It provides a kind of a abstraction. Abstraction is hiding the unknown details, hiding the data from the user and providing the implementation which is required to the user. Abstraction helps us to reuse the data. In case of data structures, abstraction is very useful. Abstraction gives the details to the user without providing the implementation details of the data structure. So the basic advantages of data structures are: first one, efficiency. Next one is reusability. And the third most important is abstraction.